mapping to quite different topics. And about Dr. Hakim, he is a senior scientist from Indian Space Research Organization. He is a civil engineer. He specializes in irrigation, water management, and he is currently working with National Remote Sensing Center as a remote sensing specialist. He has more than a decade of expertise in the field of geospatial applications for monitoring and management of natural resources in general and water resources in particular. He has successfully executed various projects from national levels to micro level as a team leader as well as a product manager. His main area of interest is in research and development of new techniques, applications in the field of water resources management using medium and high resolution satellite images. He was responsible for overall project management and execution of various projects, satellite remote sensing and GIS. System performance evaluation of Indian irrigation systems, and currently he is working on development of snowmelt runoff model using geospatial inputs. Dr. Hakim, please.
Thank you very much, sir. Good evening, all of you. As the chair has told, I have been working in this field of remote sensing and GIS in water resources, and I am into the snowmelt runoff modeling. This year. I am here to present some of the work carried out by my colleagues in the field of snowmelt runoff and glacial maps, glacial lakes mapping. We have heard from people all the afternoon session about snowfall mapping, the algorithms, how to overcome the issues in snowfall mapping. But what I am going to give here is how to go further using these snowfall maps, how it will be useful for forecasting snowmelt runoff into reservoirs. And earlier speaker has told the importance of Himalaya. This slide is going to tell about the importance of Himalaya for India. In the sense, around more than 20 river systems are being fed through snowmelt from Himalayas. Okay. Out of this, 50% is the contribution of runoff in this river is 50% from Himalayas. And Indian electricity is depending on hydropower, especially 26% of the total potential is from Himalayas. And now total power potential of total India is, out of which 26% is from hydropower generation, and out of this 26%, more than 78% is from Indian Himalayan region. I am going to make presentation on two studies. One is snowmelt runoff forecast into satellite, into Bhakra reservoir from satellite basin. This forecast has been is being given operationally for last more than 10 years. Essentially, the seasonal snowmelt during summer months, that is April, May, and June every year, into the Bhakra reservoir that is located here. This is the satellite basin. And these are the observations that is available in this basin, and beyond this, it is beyond the Indian international boundary. That is one of the issue that limits the availability of ground measure information. And initially, the forecast is given the first week of April about how much snowmelt is going to flow into Bhakra reservoir during these 3 months of summer, April, May, June, together as a cumulative, how much is there. The importance of this forecast is very significant in the sense the water from this reservoir is being shared by 5 states of India, and it is a multi-purpose reservoir. Especially the water is used for power generation, irrigation, as well as domestic and industrial purposes. And the importance of this water during summer is even more significant due to the increase in requirement of energy as well as drinking water purpose. And the role of remote sensing is even more important here, because as you see here, most of the observations are available in the lower part of the basin, where you hardly have any snowfall. Whereas most of the more than 2/3 of the basin is lying outside the country, where we don't have access in terms of field data as well as any other information. So the remote sensing plays a very important role in this case. tell you more about the basin characteristics of the surplus river basin. If you see the information in this first graph, this is the annual distribution of discharge into Baka reservoir. So these are numbers of months. If you see, these are monsoon period, whereas during summer 4th, 5th, 6th month, that is April, May, June, it is contributing around 27% of the total annual inflow into the reservoir. Out of these 3 months, you see the inflow during June is more, naturally due to the melt from higher regions. That shows the importance of the forecast initially, then revise the forecast somewhere before June, because more than 50% of the inflow during these 3 months is from June. And I forgot to mention, the revised forecast is given somewhere in the month of May, the last week of May, based on additional inputs received from ground measurements. And one more important point we need to keep in mind is the variation of the discharge over the years. In April, May, June is also significant. Like here, variation is in the order of 10,000. It increases as the month, the time progresses, the variation is also more. In the sense, it is not a straightforward case to say that every month is going to be discharge inflow into the reservoir. And if you take the temperature trend during summer, and it almost follows the discharge trend in the discharge in Baka reservoir. So essentially, we have used AVHRR from NOAA for snow core area mapping, mainly using parallel cut algorithm maximum likelihood classifier with manual editing for cloud cover wherever required. And I have got 3 set of slides just to show how the snow cover accumulation and depletion is happening. So you'll be able to see the difference. I invite your attention to this portion of the basin. See, over the years, as we understood the behavior of the basin, we felt that the snow cover from this portion of the basin, that is the Tibet portion of the basin, it contributes to the runoff during the early part of the summer. That can be seen, as you see here, that gets melted. There are many reasons for this, due to the altitude as well as the snowfall condition there. This kind of variation within the basin made us to have initial forecast for this basin based on the weighted, because at the end of March, before April, we will not have any information from ground. We will have only information from the satellite data, that is only snow core area. That information, based on a weightage factor for snow contribution, snow core area from 3 sub-basins of the basin, we give the initial forecast. This is a regressional equation that has been fitted using the historical discharge data versus the weighted snow core area. And the initial forecast will be given based on that simple weighted snow core area without any involvement of ground-based measurements. Whereas during revised forecast stage, somewhere in May last week, where by the time we get the snowfall data and temperature data from the lower part of the basin from the ground, and also we try to analyze the snow depletion pattern during this period from April to May mid, and we take into account the snowfall and the snow core area for each of these 3 sub-basins. With the runoff coefficient, we have tried to fit a linear regression model, which is used for giving the revised forecast in the last week of May. This is the general, the last few years accumulation depletion pattern. We have found in this basin, the info is almost directly related to the rate of depletion during summer months. Subjected to few cases where during summer, if some sudden snowfall happens, it is going to alter your inflow value. Otherwise, in general, it is following a trend directly proportional to the snow cover area that is available as on 31st March. It is directly proportional to that total inflow, unless otherwise there is some event like this. Especially 2008, we have some event of snowfall in between. That is a temporary snowfall which has also yielded a good amount of discharge into the reservoir. And this one example, last year snow cover area percentage shown here. And this is the general forecast trend. Initial forecast will be given in the first week of April. It is in the range of 16 lakh cubic days to 12 lakh cubic days. And in general, the forecast is matching plus or minus 10% with the actual discharge data that is available somewhere in July. But in some cases, as I was telling, like in 2008, there was a normal snowfall that could not be accounted in this model because it happens after the revised forecast has been given. And by that time, the decisions have to be taken at the field, like the reservoir operation has to be taken. So we cannot take into account this kind of late changes in the events. And another area where our colleagues have been working is mapping of glacial lakes and also water bodies that is available in the Himalayas. We have carried out this kind of mapping because all of us know that many studies. I am just showing some of the examples here. Like Tawang Basin, this was done for National Hydroelectric Power Corporation. And this is done for Satluj Jal Vidyut Nigam Limited. And we are in the process of creating a map for entire Himalayas of Indian portion, Indian Himalayas for Central Water Commission. And we are in the process of doing this. And this is what I want to share with you. Thank you for your attention. During April, May and June. For 3 months discharge, how much is going to be? It's not a daily discharge forecast. This is a long-term seasonal forecast. The snowmelt due to during summer, during April, May and June, together based on the snow cover area, bearing accumulation and the starting of the glacier.